How did you get put into CBM?
Matt, funny story, actually.
Big up, Matt.
Yeah, big up, Matt.
Big up, George. Bees,
all the CBM crew.
Yeah, all of them boys, Fabe, Ram.
Yeah. You know, they're all at it. Bees, yeah, everyone. Deco. They're fucking, the style that our crew's got, I'm really proud of, you know what I mean? I love
fast
that proper West London fucking letters. You know, I'm a traditionalist. I like the kind of, like, it's come, for me, anyway, my favourite writer back in the day, letter-wise, was Bando, all that CTK stuff.
Mm.
And, like, when it came through Holland and Paris, that kind of cross-pollination, and London as well, the three of them, I think those were kind of, like, thick, really fucking aggressive, bold, kind of blocky letters. That for me, sums up London style, you know what I mean? And that's a mixture of, like, the Dutch and the French, you know, and London... It was. They all kind of started doing this similar kind of thing.
That's interesting.
Very legible, not wild style, just fucking.
So you're retracing it to the European.
Well, for me, that's what I see as a lineage. You know what I mean? People like fucking Delta, Bando, Ski, Shu. Mm-hmm. You know, all them fucking Europeans, and also, you know, Mode 2 and the TCA and them lot, they have the letters and that. And that cross-pollination, it weren't New York. It was nothing like New York style, you know what I mean? Yeah, it was like they were doing their own style. And that's what, when I first came to London in the like late 80s and I seen what was happening on the streets and the trains and that, it was all like that. And DDS, their style was all like that. You know what
crazy
I mean?
Crazy diamond cut style lettering.
Yeah,
bang,
yeah,
bang.
Yeah, sick. You know, and I'm a bit of a traditionalist, and I like to see that carrying on, you know what I mean? And it's good to see that there are writers today that are continuing to do that kind of hard, basic kind of style.
100%. And again, just people... Delta, Mode 2, I mean, Delta himself, man, like, ahead
well,
of
he,
time.
Well, he moved with the 3D stuff very, very quickly, but his early stuff, you know, was very, very much like the, you look at London pieces and dubs and that, I mean, there's a definite correlation there, you know what I mean? But Delta obviously went on and then did his 3D things, and that went to a whole new level, which was completely fucking out of this world for that time, you know?
And then Mode 2 with the cartoon realism, these things kind of moved in their own favour of that.
Yeah, it's good, man.
Yeah. So, I mean, CBM, just going back to that, I do feel, I was just looking as I got a bees map up there. Yeah. You know, I mean, you know, there's others, there's PFB.
Of course.
You know, WD and other people, DDS, of course, hold tight to you.
Yeah.
You know, KTC, I mean, then the list goes on. But there's something about CBM in West London where I just feel like, you know, so it's a London stronghold.
Yeah.
They get about, but there is... so much diversity within that crew.
It
seems almost very, feels thought through.
The thing that's good though is that everyone influences each other's style. You know, it's not formulaic. It's like when new people come in, you can see where their influence is coming from by other writers in the crew, do you know what I mean? Which is like an old school kind of like attitude, you know? Mm-hmm. You'd bring people in and they'd learn from like the top boys in that crew and they'd pass down outlines and then they'd start doing them on their own. Mm. And before you know it, they've got the style as well and everyone's carrying that torch, you know what I mean? And I like that kind of lineage. You can see that a crew has got a style. Mm. Instead of having like fucking 10 different styles, it's good that, you know, some crews have loads of people that have all different styles. That's fine. Whatever that is, that's up to them. But what I like about CBM is that they've got that proper West London kind of like they're holding that fucking torch for the old school, you know.
100%. Big up Pure as well. He's another.
Oh, yeah, guy. Yeah. My man.
Yeah.
Top boy, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Love
proper.
Pure, mate.
I mean, I can't... There's a lot of fault lines with CBM. Mm. And a lot of the crews, they intermix and interplay.
Yeah.
You're very loyal to the CBM family.
Oh, without a doubt. Matt put me in, gave me that... dare I say a cosign, but as soon as he put me in, that was me, hit the ground running, bang, I'm fucking going all city with this motherfucker, you know?
Sometimes it only takes one incentive, to be in a class of crew, that's what sends you off, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. But, yeah, we got some heavy hitters now. It's like there's a lot of style in our crew. There always have been. And I say, you know, I'm privileged that I'm a kind of like, I'm not one of the main crew members, I'm on the periphery, but I'm doing my thing, you know what I mean? And whenever we all meet up, we smash it, you know what I mean? It's good. Mm. It's like, it's. I wish I could see her more than I do, but I'm just representing as much as I can.